وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi barakatuh. The subject we're going to cover today, Brother Lotfi, is there are some people, they question themselves, think to themselves like, why do I only have daughters and I don't have sons? And they despise and they ask the question, and they may make dua to Allah. What would you advise on that?
Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. A Muslim who believes in Allah and the last day and Rasulullah s.a.w. should also believe in the sixth pillar of Iman, the qadr khayrihi wa sharrihi. The sixth pillar of Iman is to believe in the divine destiny, the good and the bad of it. Without this belief, one can't be Muslim. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ We believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destined for us our provisions and our sustenance before we were born, وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدِ And a Muslim should do their best, strive hard to learn how to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever He provides you with, whether wealth, whether family, whether whatever it is, education, status, be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As when it comes to having daughters or sons, It is not your choice, it's absolutely the choice of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ In Surah Shura, Allah says, To Allah belongs the kingdom of the heavens and earth. يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ He creates whatever He wishes. يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ إِنَاثًا وَيَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ الذُّكُورِ He gives to whom He wishes girls, and He gives to whom He wishes boys. أَوْ يُزَوِّجُهُمْ ذُكَرَانًا وَإِنَاثَ وَيَجْعَلُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ عَقِيمًا Or he combines for you as a parent, he will give you some daughters and some sons within one family, وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدِ And some Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes them عَقِيم barren, like they can't have children. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ قَدِيرٌ The ayah ends by, indeed Allah is عَلِيم, the all-knowing, قَدِيرٌ, the all-powerful, capable of doing anything and everything at any time in anywhere. سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ So he knows, he ended the ayah by saying he's عَلِيم, he's the all-knowing. Allah says, وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ Allah knows and you do not know. In here, a Muslim should submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times without despairing from His mercy and His kindness. Subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluh. In this ayah, we learn that it is He who created whatever He creates, whatever He wishes. And it is not your choice to have daughters or sons. It's His choice. Mm-hmm. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. He made that clear. يَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ إِنَاثًا He gives to whomever He wishes daughters. وَيَهَبُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ ذُكُورٌ And He gives to whomever He wishes males. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can't question Allah's wisdom, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This will lead you to the path of misguidance, and misguidance will lead you to disbelief in such matters and confusions. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ And it's a blessing to have daughters, walillahi alhamd, as Islam teaches us, and there will be a protection for you from the fire, and one of the reasons entering Jannah, as the narrations of the ahadith of Rasulullah reported to us, and the Prophet had four daughters, starting with Zainab al-Kubra, Kulthum, Fatima, and Ruqayya, alayhinna as-salamu ajma'in, and Lot alayhi salam had daughters, and many other anbiya, and many other sahaba, Abu Bakr had Aisha radiallahu anha, Umar had Hafsa, and many more, walillahi alhamd. Walillahi alhamd. So in here, we understand that this cultural views or beliefs that there's a curse upon someone who has only daughters and so on and so forth, this goes back to the Jahiliyyah time before Islam came to free humanity from paganism and bring them into monotheism of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the olden times in Arabia, وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ Allah tells us in the Qur'an that وَإِذَا بُشِّرَ أَحَدُهُمْ بِالْأُنْثَى ظَلَّ وَجْهُهُ مُسْوَدًّا وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ When one of those pagans in Arabia will be told that he has a daughter, a new daughter is born to him, his face will become gloomy and dark and full of grief and sadness. يتوارى من القوم من سوء ما بشر به. He would hide from his community members. He is ashamed of the fact that he is blessed with a daughter. يتوارى من القوم من سوء ما بشر به. أيمسكه على هون أم يدسه في التراب. Should he keep her and accept the shame and whatever is from his community, or bury her alive? Mm-hmm. Or bury her alive? Lots of them bury their daughters alive. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. And Allah also سبحانه وتعالى mentioned in the Quran الكريم وإذا الموؤودة سئلت بأي ذنب قتلت. The girls who were buried alive will be questioned on the Day of Judgment. For what reason were you murdered? For what reason were you killed? Like Allah will not question these innocent girls, but He will question their killers and their murderers, whether their parents or guardians, whoever they are. And Allah will give them their full justice on that day, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is absolutely forbidden. And then the mercy of Islam came. The Prophet of Islam came, as Allah says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We did not send you except as a mercy to everything that exists, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. When he came, he started teaching them that it is Allah's choice. The ayat we narrated earlier, the ahadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ عَالَ جَارِيَتَيْنِ حَتَّى تَبْلُغَ جاء يوم القيامة أنا وهو وضم أصابعه صلى الله عليه وسلم. Whoever looks after two daughters, in one narration three daughters, and in some narration one daughter, he will come on the Day of Judgment. You look after her until she reaches maturity and puberty, and you marry her to someone, inshallah ta'ala, you will come on the Day of Judgment, and you will be very close to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He put his hands together. Mm-hmm. It means you will be in al-Firdaus al-A'la, the highest part of Jannah. This is what it means to be close to the Messenger of Allah on that day sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another hadith, he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من كان له ثلاث بنات أو ثلاث أخوات أو بنتان أو أختان فأحسن إليهن واتقى الله عز وجل فيهن أدخله الله عز وجل الجنة. رواه أنس بن مالك في سنن الترمذي. Whoever has three daughters or three sisters or two daughters or two sisters, and he looks after them very well, and he fears Allah when it comes to their right, Allah will enter you Jannah. Allah will enter you Jannah. Another narration, there will be protection for you from the fire. Walillahi alhamd. What a great virtue. You should never despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah might bless you with two daughters, three daughters, five daughters, six daughters, and no sons at all. Bear in your mind that this is good for you. This is good for you. عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ لَهُ خَيْرٌ. As the Prophet says, amazing are the affairs of the believers. Every matter of a believer is good for him, is good for you. Every affair that, everything that Allah gives you, whether hardship or goodness, it's good for you, for as long as you remain patient and thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a Muslim should not despair from the mercy of Allah. You have every right to wish and to hope that you have sons or daughters or mm-hmm. both. That is your right. But if Allah blessed you with one and not the other, whether sons only or daughters only, be grateful. And sure, you can always supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees that you need that, He will give it to you. But if He sees that it is not good for you, then He will not give it to you. And we know the story in Surah Al-Kahf, the boy who Al-Khidr and alayhi salam killed for a hikmah which Allah knew best. Why? Because if he grew up, he would have exhausted his parents with what? With disbelief, rebellions, and disobedience. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his life in a wisdom which he knows best, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if Allah does not bless you with something, do not despair. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. You might dislike something, whereas it is good for you. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ. You might like something, while what? While it is not good for you. So you might dislike something that's good for you, and you might like something that's not good for you. And Allah says at the end of the ayah, وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah knows and you do not know. So as a Muslim, implement Islam by fully submitting and surrendering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and accepting that which He destined for you. Allah ta'ala a'lam.
Sure. And everything that we don't have and don't have, alhamdulillah, I can also vouch for having a daughter because I have one myself.
They're beautiful.
And so, you know.
They are beautiful. They're definitely loving, they're caring.
Yeah.
I think only a pure ignorant person would question such questions. Yeah. Someone who's really purely ignorant would question why I have a daughter or two or three and don't have sons. May Allah guide us and guide them.
Okay. Thank you very much for the love fee. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.